हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम असित कुमार साहू। इन इन दिस सेशन ऑफ वैल्यू एडिशन थ्रू वैल्यू चेन वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वेस्ट्स दैट आर सीन इन अ रूरल सप्लाई चेन। सो इन ऑर्डर टू कन्वर्ट अ रूरल सप्लाई चेन इनटू वैल्यू चेन, वी नीड टू आइडेंटिफाई दिस वेस्ट एंड ऑल्सो वी शुड ट्राई टू मिनिमाइज दिस वेस्ट। There are generally seven different types of waste that occur during the supply chain of most of the business. In rural supply chain, these are the ones which have to be tackled to convert the supply chain into a value chain. The first waste we will be discussing about is the overproduction. This happens when the produce is produced first and then the wait for orders. Do not deliver the produce before they are needed and avoid created demand where a quantity greater than what is needed is requested. In most of the times, this waste is difficult to handle, as in our country most farmers rely heavily on the factors that are not in their control. Factors like the arrival of monsoon, amount of rainfall received in a particular season. So these are not in control of a farmer, and many a times good harvest or bad harvest is dependent on factors beyond the control of the farmer, which I just discussed. But however, with contract farming which is gaining momentum, forecasting the harvest is gradually becoming easier. So then we'll be discussing about the second waste, that is the delay or waiting between the activities. Due to lack of proper planning and sequencing of activities, there is wastage of time between the end of one activity and the start of the next activities. We will take some examples to clarify this point. The first one is arrival of truck and the loading of the truck. If a time is set that a truck will arrive at this time to take the harvested produce to the mandi. For example, let we have informed the truck driver to come to the farm at 10 o'clock. But at that time the laborers are not available to load the truck. And the laborers are coming after lunch, that is after 2 p.m. or at 3 p.m. So there is a delay. So this type of delays need to be controlled. Another example is the delay between receiving the customer's order information and beginning to work on fulfilling the order is wasteful. Many a times farmer carry their harvest to mandi, and due to the limited space inside the mandi, they have to wait outside. So when they are waiting, there is a chance that the harvested crop is damaged, and it also increases the cost of the transport through which they have brought all their harvested produce to the mandi. And the third waste we will be discussing about is the transportation and the conveyance. Layout of the workplace should be in a sequence which should be similar to the sequence of the activities in a value chain. This will help to avoid unnecessary back and forth movement leading to time waste. Activities of harvesting, processing, storing, transportation, etc. should be subsequently laid out to avoid delay and back and forth movement. So this is an example of efficient farm layout. Here you can see the main road is just adjacent to the supply storage and the produce storage, so that all the produce can be directly loaded and unloaded from the vehicle that will be parked in the main road. And now the fourth one is unnecessary motion. Unnecessary movement by the workers also leads to leads to wastage of time. It also includes extra travel or transit due to lack of proper and sufficient storage arrangement. Some of the reasons are workers and equipment factors, inefficient ergonomics, unnecessary walking, reaching or twisting, improper positioning of the equipment in the workplace, and poor workplace design. The meaning of ergonomics is the study of people's efficiency in their working environment. So the fifth wastage is inventory mismanagement. This is one of the most common sources of waste. So always always a optimum amount of inventory should be there in the storage. Less or excess inventory both lead to waste. Any logistics activities that leads to more inventory being positioned than needed, or any activities which results in lack of inventory at right place, occupying space or allowing space to remain unutilized, is categorized as waste. Some of the examples are early deliveries, receipt of order for quantity greater than requirement, and inventory in the wrong distribution center. The most inventory wastage are due to ill planning of waste in products, services and information, unnecessary stock of raw materials, parts or work in progress, excess or low inventory due to products, services not linked to customer's requirement, or interruption in the chain, making extra products just in case. Then comes the last, that is errors. Errors can be of two types, that is human or machine errors. But these errors always lead to waste. Such errors lead to rework, unnecessary adjustment or returns, such as billing errors, inventory disparities and adjustment, and damaged, defective, wrong and miserable product. Organization address this challenge by developing a comprehensive set of performance metrics that align overall execution with strategy and eliminate the conflicting performance objective by the department. So in the next session we'll be discussing about the activities in a rural value chain. Thank you so much.